Hello, hello, hi Petra, hi Mystic, hi Cage, Axel. Hope everyone's doing okay today. I got a rare Saturday where no one was around, so I wanted to do another nom nom nommy. Yeah. Doing good, grabbing a quick lunch before heading shopping for work. Hopefully it goes well for you, Kadris. Glad you decided to stop by for a few minutes. Thank ya. Yeah, I took my hat off today. This gives me an idea for a Salix design. Are you at least doing fun shopping? Ooh, valid question. You're back at it with Nom Nom Nommy. I really, like, I don't know. After Syrup and Bad in Theater, it's like, okay, I really like this artist. Syrup was so cute, and then Bad in Theater just hit me in the chest, man. Like, it hit me where it hurt. Bad in Theater was brilliant. And I want to get to Lonely Wolf Treat. We're gonna get there, I promise. There are just a few other ones I want to do too. Office supplies, the most exciting of shopping. Find some good pens, and then what you do is you go to Michael's and look for journals. Or go on Etsy. Like some artist on journals are so cute. This thing. Okay, but like, I can kill out of staples. Yeah. Okay, you ready to see how many voices I can do today? My guess is not very many. We're gonna try though. And let me know if audio starts being an issue again, because for whatever reason, my mic's been obnoxious lately. So apparently it keeps cutting out really bad. Econ and Crow on Etsy have some for... Oh god, I love me a good journal. I'm a journal fiend. Okay. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and hit start. We're gonna see how this goes. Ooh, there's a rewind button. Ooh. Darkness. Darkness and nothing. In all directions. At some point, I started thinking, shouldn't there be something here? Something anywhere? So I started looking. I don't know what exactly I was looking for. But as I wondered, a spot of light in the distance. This is a fun one. Ooh, yee. As I approached, I found another. And another. A trail of burning bright lights. I traveled out and away, their steady glow piercing tiny holes in the darkness. They fascinated me. I decided to walk until I reached the source. I found a girl. She was sitting on a bed of those stars. It was a beautiful sight. Oh, someone's here. My nose is clogged. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do the sniffles and stuff. What should I say to her? Are you crying? Excuse me, but have you been crying? I felt so lonely. I just can't seem to stop. But now someone's here. I didn't think anyone would come, but you're here. Oh, I'm so happy. If you're happy, then stop crying. Honestly, Space. How did you know my name? I don't know. It just slipped out. How did I know her name? Never told it to me. But something about her feels familiar. Like an old friend. Fair. I didn't even get to introduce myself. And now I have to ask for your name. It's time. 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 Time, 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 time. Time. What are you doing? Saying it 8 times will help me remember. 8 is the... Is on... Bleh. I know how to read. 8 on its side is infinity. That's how I'll never forget. I see. Hello, Time. Where did you come from? I don't know. To start. If I had to give it a name, I'd call it The Start. The Start? Yes, it would make sense to begin at the start. Does that make where we are now the middle? But you started here, didn't you? I don't know if we can call it the middle. Can! This place has changed. Has it? Yes, you're here with me now, Time. So before it was the start, and now it is the middle. It made sense in its own way. This girl was very straightforward. So, if there's a beginning, is there an end? Who knows? Probably. It would make sense for that to be the case. You think so too? I wonder what it's like. What if the end is sad? The start was lonely. Will the end be lonely too? I don't want that. You cry a lot, don't you? Yes, because look! Whatever I do, these stars come out. I had already noticed, but maybe it'd be rude to point that out. I can't really explain it, but somehow, they make me feel a little less lonely. So, from the start, you've just been here making stars? Yes! You see, where there's nothing, I want to put something. Does that make sense? I guess it does. What kinds of things do you do, Time? Move the universe. I can make the universe move. Forwards, backwards. I can jump to any moment I've already experienced. Wow, that sounds like hard work. Making stars sounds harder to me. Oh, that's easy. Watch. I don't mean to make you cry again, actually. Actually, this is a good chance to demonstrate. Huh? Alright, I remember the outcome. Oh, this is gonna get interesting, isn't it? Said stop making stars, so then I can try to stop her from crying. I need to. Hey, don't start crying just to prove how you see it, okay? What I was about to do. That's my power. You already cried before, but I went back to the moment before you did in order to stop you. Wow. Well, Time? It was nothing, really. You know something? I only just met you, but it feels like we've always known each other. I did know your name from the first moment I saw you, so maybe your feeling is true. But I can't remember talking with you like this before now. Just like I can't remember crying before you changed what happened. It must be a paradox. Hey, how did you find me in the first place? I just followed your stars. And here you were. Oh, that means, hey, if we ever get separated, I can just cry. That way you'll always be able to find me. Sure, but I don't know if I like the thought of making you cry. You as long as you're here with me. I'm kind of afraid to go back to being alone. Alright, how's today? It doesn't seem like there's anyone else out there anyway, so I have no reason to leave. Huh? Anyone else? Honey? There is someone else out there. Don't you think we should try to look for them? Yes, we should. You don't want them to feel lonely, do you? Exactly! I'm so happy you understand time. We wandered into the void together, see if we could find anything else out there. But all we found was darkness. And the more darkness we found, the more space would cry. I didn't like seeing her cry. I didn't want her to feel lonely. Much to my relief, she agreed to rest when I suggested it. I closed my eyes for a while, but when I opened them again, I was back in the dark. Space? No response. What happened? All the stars are gone too. Did I make a mistake? I'll rewind from here, before I close my eyes. I won't close my eyes this time. I have to pay attention. I don't want to miss what caused everything to go black. Hi. You look so serious all of a sudden. Something strange happened, but I don't know what it was. Something strange? Scanning the cosmos, I noticed something seemed to be blotting out a group of stars in the distance. I spotted the anomaly. I could just barely make it out against the dark background of the void. There was someone out here after all. As soon as I noticed I'd spotted them, they disappeared. I squinted toward the area that I had been standing only a moment before, thinking I could easily find them again in such a distance. But very suddenly, she appeared right behind space. What are you? Mill. Face rides through space, somehow erasing her from existence. The stars around us dimmed and faded as she disappeared. This is what happened before. This is what I missed by taking my eyes off of her. It was awful. I wanted it to stop. Her space once stood before me. There was now only Nil. What have you done to space? The stars! You took away all the beauty. Now all that is left is the void. But it is beautiful like this too, isn't it? No. No, I don't like it. Bring back space. Bring back her stars. If that's how you feel, I'll lock you in this moment until you understand. No. Does it tell me how far back to go? Why? Why can't I rewind past this point? If I go forward, all I see is space right through space, somehow erasing her from existence. All the stars around us dimmed, faded as she disappeared. This is what happened before. This is what I missed by taking my eyes off of her. It was awful. I wanted it to stop. Space once stood before me. There's now only Nil. Why are you stopping me from rewinding? Why can't I go back and protect space from you? That wouldn't be fair. Fair? It's not fair that you suddenly took her away. You don't like it? No. No, I don't like it. Bring back space. Bring back her stars. That's how you feel. I'll lock you in this moment. I go for. Is it really gonna just. Am I stuck here already? What else I can do? What's warp do? Huh? So do I just miss? There's nothing else I can do here? Oh, no, I click. Oh, I didn't realize that was an option. I'm dumb, don't worry about it. No, but what can I do? I originated to the start. If I start over now, I could change this. Otherwise, I'll be trapped in this loop. Ah. Okay. Darkness. Direction. I knew someone was out there. I just had to find her again. So I started looking. I wanted to find space. And as I retraced my steps, I spotted her light in the distance. There was space, sitting on a bed of her stars. Just like I remembered. Oh, someone's here! What should I say to her this time? You're alive! I thought something terrible happened, but you're right here. I'm glad you're still okay. Huh? She looked at me like she'd never seen me before. Because she hadn't seen me before. This space was new. How could I have expected her to remember what happened? My excitement to see her alive and well, I'd forgotten that rule. I decided to try recreating the first story. Never mind. Excuse me, but have you been crying? I felt so lonely. I can't seem to stop. But now someone's here. I didn't think someone would come, but you're here. Well, I'm so happy. If you're happy, then stop crying. Honestly, space. Huh? How do you know my name? Of course I know your name. Even though you didn't tell it to me the first time, either. This isn't fair! I can't even introduce myself! And I have to ask me your name! It's time. Time! What are you doing? Dang it, 8 times will help me remember. 8 on its side is infinity. That's how I'll never forget! IQ. Did I hear stationery? Did. Recently found a fun stationery shop on Etsy. Yeah, Cadrus is going office supply shopping. So we, like, it wasn't very long, but we talked about stationery for a minute. Like I said, I've got a weakness for journals and pens. But. Hi, Q. Okay. I'm gonna have to mess. I downloaded a voice meter. I'm gonna have to mess with it. Oh, I have a strong weakness for stationery in general. I'm sure you know. True. And stretch too. There we go. Hey, Mythic, what's up? Yeah? Except it's impossible for you to remember when I go back to before I told you. So, time. Where did you come from? Future? Would you believe me if I told you I came from the future? When I thought I was all alone, you proved me wrong. I'll believe whatever you say. Besides, there's this feeling in my chest that you're definitely someone I can trust. I'm glad. Well, it's true. I did come from. We've already met before, and you wanted to search this void to see if we can find anyone else, or anything else. That does sound like something I'd want to do. Did we find anyone? Someone found us, but it's hard to explain what happened. I don't want to scare her. We didn't find anyone. That's why I think we should stay together. Oh, it would be sad if there was someone out there. And they were feeling as lonely as I was. I lied to her. Said she'd believe whatever I'd say, and I took advantage of that trust. But I didn't know how to tell her what happened. I wanted to avoid the ending I saw before. This path didn't lead somewhere better. I could always make a save point and rewind from there. Wait, time? If you're from the future, why did you come here? Well, so I'd be able to talk to you again. Then, in the future, we're not able to talk anymore? Oh no! Uh-oh. I'll reassure her so she doesn't start crying again. Yes, we were separated. But I'm going to change that so it doesn't happen. That's a relief. I should figure out a backup plan too, so that you're not the only one working hard at this. Hey! How did you find me in the first place? That's easy. I already knew where you'd be waiting for me. I'm talking about the very first meeting. Before you knew where I was, what about then? I just followed your stars. And here you were. Oh, that means, hey, if we ever get separated, I can just cry. That way you'll always be able to find me. Sure, but I don't know if I like the thought of making you cry. I won't have to, as long as you're here with me. I'm kind of afraid to go back to being alone. I don't want to be alone either. I'm glad you feel the same, Time. Would it be alright to just lay here together? Just for a little while. If you want to, then I don't mind. Space and Time make me think of Pokemon. Oh my god. I held her hand so that no one would be able to sneak up on us. Our fingers interlaced so easily. It was as if they belonged together like this. But that was impossible. That feeling, even if it didn't make any sense, only made me hold tighter. As long as I held on to Space, Neil wouldn't be able to take her away. We could lie here and admire the stars together, and never do anything else. I'd be satisfied, just like this. Hi, can I ask you something? What is it? What happened before? What was it that you came back and ordered the change? I already told you, we got separated. I know, but I definitely would have been crying if that happened. Couldn't you have followed my stars? I couldn't. You weren't able to make them anymore. That's terrible. Yeah, it was. I'm glad you came back. If we couldn't find each other, I'd want to change that too. We lay there in silence for a while. I had a feeling Space could sense I was waiting for something. She didn't ask what. As long as I held on to her, she had nothing to worry about. Still, surely she was watching us from somewhere. The light from Space's stars didn't reach. I wanted to be ready. I wanted to be able to stop her when she appeared. But we fell asleep. No. No! I let it happen again. I lost Space again! Time. Don't go back anymore. Why are you doing this? Just gonna trap me here again, isn't she? Stay. Hey. 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 Oh. Oh. Okay. Darkness. Darkness and nothing in all directions. I knew what I had to do. I started looking for Space. And as I wandered, I spotted a familiar light in the distance. Hey, first Alex, you're my fantasy. Ah! Hello! Welcome. I'm afraid this isn't going to be a very exciting one because it's a visual novel, but I'm glad you decided to stop by for a minute. Oh, someone's here! What should I say to her? I want to save you. Space, listen carefully. Someone called Nil is going to come and take you and all of your beautiful stars away. Huh? Please trust me. My name is Time. I come from a future where that's what always happens in the end. I don't understand. I know it's a lot to take in. I want to protect you. I don't want Nell to take you away. I'm folding laundry anyway. Always good to get chores done. Well, hey, let me know how my voice acting is, because I don't think it's very good, but... That's why we're doing visual novels, it's practice. That's the excuse I'm using. I'm sorry. Oh, thank you for the follow! I appreciate it. I'm sorry I let myself get taken away. It's not your fault, Space. You don't want to be all alone either, do you? If you feel the same as me, then it must have hurt. It's okay. I'm able to come back and prevent things like this. Please don't cry. Okay. I told Space about the other versions of our meetings that I knew of. I told her that Nell was somehow able to limit my power, trapping me in loops and keeping me from rewinding far enough to stop her whenever she appeared. Sounds so incredibly cute and soft. Hi. Hello. Thank you. Thank you. You came just in time. We're doing a visual novel, so we're gonna... Like I said before, I don't really have a lot of practice, so... My voice is... My range isn't very big. But that's okay. We can try. Felix is always... Well, I take good care of my fur. Thank you. And when I'm in this form, of course you have to take care of your hair, too. Face wanted to help. Hi, Felix. Comfy. Yeah, we're trying to be comfy cozy. Just doing some visual novels. Oh, let me know if the audio starts cutting out, though. Because I know my mic's been kind of acting up recently. So, I guess the audio's been kind of going in and out on me. I do a lot of tabletop games. I practice accents and I don't get a lot of them, but it helps get more focal range, at least. Yeah. I was invited to do a TTRPG, like virtually, but like I was invited to do one recently, and I know the DM sent over the list of possible stories we could do, so I need to go back and reread that to see what's up with that. But yeah, like I know my focal range isn't very wide, but I do want to get a little bit better, and visual novels are a good way to do that, I guess. Especially if I'm sitting here all by myself, so I'm the only one reading like 7 different voices. My range isn't very wide. But... Ooh, TTRPG! Yee! So we'll see how that goes. And it's with other people that I know. But it's not like it's a bunch of strangers, or I probably wouldn't have agreed. But... Okay. And Space wanted to help. She said if we worked together, we might have a chance. It was better than trying to fight this monster on my own. Nell seems to only appear when we let our guard down. I tried waiting before, but we fell asleep. Then, we have to make the first move. But what should we do? I don't know. If I could go back far enough, just enough to know exactly what's going to happen, so that I'd be able to fix it, the only way I'd been able to learn anything is through seeing you get taken away. I don't want to watch that happen again. You're working hard, aren't you? I want to help. I don't want you to feel alone. I'm still here, so I hope I can do something for you. We stayed like this for a while. Oh, that's precious. Does it say something if I think this is too happy and I'm working with the angst? Nell's gonna show up again, wait. Hi, what? Hello! Then again, I'm a spaghetti. No, Nell's taken Space away a couple of times now. We stayed like this for a while. It was warm. It felt nice. I considered pausing the universe here, in this moment. After all, moving forward could cause something awful to happen again. and it was up to me whether or not to let this path play out. But I knew I didn't have to be afraid, because I wasn't alone. Ah, there she is. Yeah, Nell had already shown herself. Why are you doing this? This is Nell? Why do you look like me? You're the copy. Why won't you stay erased? Space, run! I'll stop her. I don't want to be separated from you. It's only temporary. I promise I'll be able to find you later. So get out of here. Like this. I don't like this. In an instant, Nell's body blinked out of existence. Slipped through my grasp. And once again, this was gone. Was there nothing I could do? Nell had beaten me no matter what I tried. My attempts to change fate were only hurting space again and again. Why won't you look at me? Keep taking space away. Of course I wouldn't want to look at someone who'd do that. You're crying for her? I felt so overwhelmed by hopelessness. I'd barely noticed my tears. How strange, I thought. For me to cry so easily. Space was always the one who... And there it was again. The feeling I'd known her much longer than I possibly could have. I didn't understand these feelings. Aren't you going to reset again? What's the point if you'll always... Again? She said again. Then, she remembers the other times that I... I asked you before... What are you? I am Nil. Emptiness. Void. Whatever you want to call me. Wherever there is something, I want to make it nothing. Does that make sense? Why would you want to do that? You exist just to take space away? Space exists to take me away. Why can't you understand? Must I explain it to you? Please, listen. You're still here. You really listen to me? Just say what you want to say. I know why she's doing all this. I'll be able to think of a way to stop her. But there's another feeling in my heart when I look at her. Sympathy? Why? Very beginning. Very, very beginning. It was alone. It was only in the thick, empty, infinite darkness that surrounds us now. At some point, I thought I wanted there to be more than just that. That's when I changed from nothing to something. That was also when you first appeared, Tan. From that point on, I felt like we were all there ever was, and all there would ever be. One time, in one space, and no one else. We had so much fun together. I thought it would last for all eternity. But then, my light faded, and you stopped. You stopped, but I was still here. I was still here, but you rewound to be with the light I'd left behind. I waited for the end to come. I think maybe I could reach you there. But whenever it came, you would just rewind again, be with another new me. Another new space. Made me so jealous. I waited so long for you to finally find me. How could you? I couldn't cry. couldn't create any light of my own for you to follow. We found new lights for stars. You forgot about me. How could that be true? I don't have any memories like that. There's no way I would forget about space. But you did, again and again. She always returns to nothing, to me, and you always go back to the beginning. Never stay with me. Always want to stay with space, but not Nil. It's because my darkness isn't as beautiful. Nil always choose her stars over me. I erased everything. All of the universes. Started over with just one. Just one for you and me. But space is always there too. You always go to her. Is that why I can't remember it? Because you erased the universe that held those memories? You know what all the universes are now? It's you and space together, and I'm alone. That's why I wanted to bring you to the end faster. I even learned how to stop you from rewinding. When I erased her, I could finally reach you, but you only got mad at me. I'd finally set everything right, but you didn't understand anything at all. I was stupidly hoping you would remember everything if you could just see me again. I was so angry when you didn't. How could I recall memories that were erased? Unless these feelings in my heart. I still can't stop you from resetting. I can't stop you from doing what's always brought you closer to her. You've been going further and further away. I didn't know what to do anymore. I didn't want to have to explain it all to you like this. I wanted you to remember on your own. I can't take this anymore. Nil. Even if those memories are erased for me, they still left an impression in my heart. And that impression, that love has driven my every action up to this point. But you and space are connected. All of my memories with you are with who space is now. That's how I got confused. I don't want to hear that. Thanks to you, I finally understand what I've been feeling all along. And it's that you were someone who was very precious to me. Even if those feelings were projected onto a you who wasn't you anymore, I'm sorry now. You're so mean. You treated me like I was the bad one. I was the one who messed up from the start. Can you ever forgive me? All I wanted was to be at your side again. You forgot about me. I won't forgive you so easily. That's fine. I'll work hard to make it up to you. Good. You'll have all of eternity to do that. Just the two of us. Just the two of us, huh? Every time I get thinking about visual novels, I think in the vice they were in a good way. Grass restoration. So good. Ooh, I haven't heard of that one. I am noticing audio cutting, but I don't know if it's my lens. It might be lag. Seems good. Okay. Let me know. Okay, so the question is, do I want to stay with Nil, or do I want to go back for space again? Because I really don't want to hurt Nil again after that, but I also don't want to abandon space. Choices. What do we do? How painful do we want to make this? Because she's not going to be happy if I go back again. But I don't want to just abandon space. I'm getting to the good part, but I have to get some lunch. Have fun making choices. Have fun with your lunch. Registration is about a super talented drummer in high school who loses an arm. And I can already see the angst possibilities. Yep, I'm hungry too. Okay, hang on. I want to save Okay, yeah, we'll overwrite that. Always saying it's true. We'll save at Nil's story, and then hopefully I'll be able to start from here again. I'm about to hurt myself. I don't want to do this to- I really don't want to do this to her. I have to go back. I'm sorry, Nil. I promised Space I would go back to her. No! Why? Am I not enough for you? Staying here would mean I'm forgetting a part of you again. And I don't want that. I'm not gonna leave any part of you all alone. Do you understand? I do understand. But I still don't like it. What can I do in order for you to accept this, then? If you're really serious, return to the beginning. I want to start over with you. And instead of looking for Space first, you have to find me instead. Okay? You promise you'll come find me first. Promise. No, after all this, I can't abandon her like that. I promise. Yes, I promise to come and find you first. Good. It's a promise. Alright, Nil. I'll see you again soon. Ready? we have to find Nil. Please say that we remember that we have to find Nil. Darkness. Darkness and nothing in all directions. Nil was somewhere out here in this emptiness. You've been waiting for me all along. You found me. Oh, good. I promised I would. You also promised we'd never be apart. You promised I was the only one you'd ever love. You promised. Hold on. You're talking about a version of me who's not around anymore. I personally haven't promised you anything like that. Getting about it is no excuse. Still holding you to everything you said in the past. You're pretty strict. This is your punishment for everything you put me through. Fine. As long as you don't start making things up to get me to do whatever you want. I'll be fair. Are you ready to meet Space? No. She isn't going to like me. She won't remember what you did before. And if we told her, I think she'd understand how you felt. What's wrong? You really don't want to meet her? It's not that. It's just... we have to go right away. I still haven't forgiven you yet. Well, that's how it is. Maybe if you'd give me a kiss, perhaps I'd forgive you a little bit. Oh, you're really cute. That's Fred. Oh my god, baby. Oh, kiss. No. Okay, she's precious. Wait. We'd fallen right back into place, as if I'd never been gone. Look how cute! Oh my god, hi. This is Precious. Hello. Your touch felt so familiar. How could I have ever forgotten it? You must have had a million of these kinds of encounters before. Why else would it have felt so natural? Every moment like this, that was lost to me. I'd have to make new memories to replace them. One by one. Oh, these stars. They don't feel lonely. Their light feels happy. Oh, someone's here. Okay, hi. That's... it's really sweet. Wait. Good end. That was really sweet. Aww. Good play. Oh, that was precious. Okay, so that's gonna. I'm crying. This is too fucking adorable. It said it was a short one. I didn't realize it was only. It's like less than an hour level short. But that was really sweet. Like, that was precious. Oh, I'm still missing two endings in a memory. But I don't. No, I'm gonna go back and do that after I got the good end. I don't know. I don't think I want to go back and do that after getting the good end. That was precious. Illustration. Okay. Time, space. Got the good end, so now you need to suffer through the bad end. See, typically, I'm the person, I prefer to do bad ends first. But I couldn't do that to Nil. Emotional roller coaster 100% speedrun. We had our high, do we need to hit the low? Oh, you can get an ending with, okay. Well, now we know we can get an ending with space, too, because I didn't know about that. I wasn't expecting. Normally, they don't show you artwork if you haven't unlocked it. Well, that was really good, though. So you can have an ending where you're like, that was space, too. Okay. Same. Yeah, right? It's like... Ooh. Author's note. Hello, welcome to the developer commentary. Her Tears for My Lay was originally made for a game jam in 2016. Production only took 1 month. Wow. This is now 2020 as I'm writing this. I decided to reuse a lot of my notes from the art collection I released with the game back then. I don't remember my thoughts from so many years ago. So I'm glad I wrote them somewhere. Hope you enjoy. Oh, this is all like the production notes. Okay, this is cute. And look how cute. Oh. Even just the little sketches are really cute. Like, Nom Nom Nami's art is precious. I keep my original design notes, but I think I have an hourglass motif. Oh, I didn't even realize that was an hourglass. That's cute. Wait, I didn't realize that. Her bow? Oh my god, that's amazing. In space. Billowy and light. Aww. I really like the colors on both space and nil. Like, this is cute. Oh. Photo studio? Oh, wait, can you make your... You can edit the background yourself? Nil has time ribbons. Oh, this is... Look, everything about this is gonna make me cry. This is so good. Oh. And then you can sit there and make your own pictures. Take photo. Oh. Okay. That was really cute. My heart is a mess. I want to go back and get the space ending, but I don't know how to do that. And I really don't want to break Nil's heart like that. But at the same time, I really want the space ending now. This is everything about Nil deserves the world. Okay, like the way she went about it, I can't really blame her. That was so... Oh my god. That was a lot. Okay, so I knew it said when I clicked on it that it was short, but I didn't really... While it's sad and cute, and all that, I'm not enough for you. Coming from Nil. Look. Let the poor thing have her thing. Okay, so there's another one on here called Contract Demon that I've kind of had my eye on. Spooky First Kiss at a Spooky Saray, Starry Flowers, Astro's Garden. There's a few other Nom Nom, or yeah, Nom Nom Nami games I want to play. Like, I'm going to do Lonely Wolf Treat eventually. I kind of want to do, I think I want to do Astro's Garden on stream. I already did Bad End Theater. Bad End Theater is a beautiful game and you should play it. Bad End Theater was really good. I'm really glad I decided to play that. Because it really put me on a rabbit hole. But yeah, okay. I think I'll save the last and a couple of endings. And I'll do them myself off stream. Just so that people have reasons to go play the game. Support Nom Nom Nami. Okay. I'll see if I can't find Brass Restoration. There's a lot of paths. Ooh, okay. Yee. Okay. So now the question is, do we want to do something else? Like, I could just wander around aimlessly in Genshin and make this a glorified just chatting. Or Power Wash Sim. It's been a minute since I've done Power Wash Sim. Or do we want to go ahead and call it? That can work. Yeah. Okay, cool. Let's go ahead and let me switch the Be Right Back really fast. Then. And if that sounds okay with you guys, then I'll go ahead and switch over, get power. I'll probably do Power Wash then. Because I already did my dailies and stuff in Genshin, so. Unless you guys want to wander around Inkonomiya with me, I hate Inkonomiya. I hate Inkonomiya. Okay. Ta-da-da. I'll just pull up game. Chops. Background noise. That's not too loud. Let me. This one's nice. Power Wash or Genshin. I finished the Lisa event today. It was one of the Easter Domain events, and I'm kind of glad. Yeah, the Lisa Domain was much, much easier than I was expecting it to be. I still ended up looking a guide just because I'm lazy, but like getting that costume. Do I want to rename? Nah, I won't read. We'll go ahead and switch the game though, before I forget about it. Oral simulator. Why are you giving me privacy policy again? I know I haven't opened this game in a while, but, what? Pull this up. Lisa is really good now with the Indra and her outfit is delicious. I'm long for a moon to play her in a serious team. Currently sidetracked by trying to and keeping up with the weekly. I think it pops up. Doing this. There we go. It's like OBS. Yeah, but okay. Like, welcome to Power Wash Simulator. You see how everything's saying new all of a sudden? They reset something? That's weird. It's like, huh. You ain't giving your head pat. Head pat my confusion away. okay. I'll go. We can go work on the fishing boat and we can just make this something chill. nice, chill Saturday afternoon. It pets to wake up the second brain cell. Please, it's cute that you think I have a second brain cell. I have one, and I share it amongst other people. That's gonna take a lot of head pets. Thank you, Kadris. Cute that you think I have a second brain cell. I appreciate the vote of confidence. Never let it be sold that I'm a smart cat. If I say that I'm smart, I'm probably lying through my teeth. Probably. Definitely. You know. Okay, well now, what was the last thing? I got the propeller done. That was all part of the... Okay, so... Oh yeah, the boat was annoying because it's got all these little like barnacle things, so they're not coming off with just the regular. Remember, back to my regularly scheduled suffering. It's just like when I say I'm nice. I mean, I don't know, Kadris. You're pretty generous as a person. You seem very nice to me. The whole GC shares the rates. There's a single brain cell. It gets passed around. We all take turns with it. Yeah. Okay, yeah. I vaguely remember thinking I wanted to despise this. It's not gonna be as bad as the treehouse. The treehouse is awful. Anyone who plays this game can tell you the treehouse is disgusting. But I don't like it when I have to look straight up, and that's what this is going to be do a lot of. Straight up and straight down. Because it makes it a lot harder to control, and it makes me surprisingly dizzy, actually. I've only watched, but yes, the treehouse is a living hell. Yes. No, the treehouse is awful. Like, I did that on... I don't think I streamed the treehouse. I'm pretty sure I did that one just on my own time. I only stream this game sometimes when I just want to chill and hang with people. So it's like, no, the treehouse, it makes me dizzy. Like when you have to look straight up, and the treehouse makes you do that quite a bit. Straight up and straight down. And there's so many little nooks and crannies. Like if you miss one of the, like the support bars, for example, you miss one of them, it's just like, you're out of luck, aren't you? You have to search the whole place to find the one bar you missed. And then sometimes this game's either super generous or it's super specific about how clean something can be to count. So when you're missing a speck of dirt, and it's like, what else do you want from me? But it's a very, I don't know, I still think it's enjoyable. Like, it is satisfying in a way, but just like deep down, it's satisfying to be able to see the difference. And then it's like, it's nice because then I can sit here and like, I'm not reading story like I was earlier, where visual novels are nice. And I want to do more of them. Like I said, to practice like voices and stuff, which is great because mommy does a lot of them apparently. But this is nice because then I can just sit here and look at chat. And we can sit here and just, you know, go on about random stuff. Like if we want to talk, a lot of my talks come to attention, but... And we wanted to talk about, like, hey, do you have any favorite mixed drinks? Or, hey, what are your favorite snacks? Or, you know, stuff like that. Or, how's your weekend? Have you done anything exciting? I haven't. This is my weekend. Like, apparently there's a dinosaur exhibit, a couple hours away or something like that. So, they took my niece to it. Like, her dad works today. But, I've got two brothers. I've got my niece's dad, and I've got another brother, so youngest brother, and my mom took small one to this dinosaur exhibit today, and then middle brother works, so I get the whole house to myself. I live across the hall. There's two apartments, and somehow the kid runs both. Mixed drinks. Yeah. Y'all want to talk mixed drinks? I have no problems with that. I'm out of apple juice. Ooh, I think I still have orange juice. I'm out of apple juice, or I'd make a drink right now, actually. I don't care if it's only 3 in the afternoon. Samosas are... Samosa. Words. Hi, I can... I tend to prefer to social drink, but if I'm social drinking, I'm a mixed drink person. I don't like straight alcohol in general, unless it's something super like low content, or like it comes like pre-mixed type of stuff. What do you like drinking? Okay, so like I like things that are, I tend to prefer things that are sweet. Like I don't like beer, I don't like ale, I don't like, you know, stuff like that. I like mixed drinks. I like give me something with Bailey's, or give me something with like Midori. But I also really like 99. 99, strong stuff, but if you mix it right, so good. Or like, I know there was one night where I had this jug of like lemonade from Walmart, you know, over by the deli section, you can get those drinks. It was one of the lemonade jugs. What did I add to it? I added like vodka and 99 lemonade. Like four different, what I think was the last of my amaretto. It tasted okay though. Cabaret battles suck and I wish for certain storms. That's my weekend. Yeah, I'm still not strong enough to raid battles. We could play Pokemon if we just want to surprise trade some more. Legitimately, the one night sat there and just surprise trade it for like 3 hours. It was cool. I had fun. I think Chad enjoyed it. My weekend, I'll be doing terror raids once done at work. What I'm hearing is that I need to go, hey, can you guys spare some Pokemon for a sad soul like me? Who is not strong enough to tear. I need to get back to Pokemon. It's admittedly been a few minutes since I've played it. Like, it's been a bit. I just want to complete Dex. And see, I was never that person in Pokemon. I am not a... Admittedly, depending on the game, some games have made me a little bit more completionist than others. Pokemon's not one of them. Depending on the raid, I can. Like I said, we could just surprise trade for a while. But if we wanted to circle back to drink, or just like I said, I like the things if you can't taste the alcohol, even if it's extremely alcoholic. But then I'm also a tea. Ooh, a cup of tea sounds. I'm farming herbs for. Ooh! It's on home account. Jeez. Less about the completion and more I want them all to be there. They gotta quit trying to push Switch so hard because it hasn't been working. I think the only Pokemon game I've more than completionist was Legends. Legends was fun. Save room for actual Pokemon. Yeah, see, I think they need to stop. Like, you don't need new Pokemon every region. You can recycle some of your Pokemon. It's fine. You can give us new regions and then recycle the Pokemon. It's A-okay, I promise. Have Oregon chat. Ooh. I was thinking of making a cup of honey vanilla chamomile. Like, that just sounds good right now. Because I don't think I'm mostly better, but because the weather keeps going up and down, my nose keeps getting congested anyway. Like, it was below freezing all day yesterday, and then today is like 25 degrees warmer or something like that. It's like, okay, the weather needs to stop. So just a cup of tea in general sounds. I mean, if they weren't trying to do massive pearls touch with the older style, they could do it. See, I feel like, yeah, no, like, even if they did the open world, give me the open world. I think that's fun, personally. But you don't have to keep coming up with new Pokemon. You can recycle old Pokemon. Or give us different regional stuff. Like, I really like the regional stuff they've been doing recently. That is what they should have been doing this whole. Yes, the weather's ridiculous. Honestly, the weather's been up and down, up and down, up and down. Like, it's no wonder I'm congested all the time. Open worlds are a bit overdone in my opinion, and isn't... I guess that's fair, but glad they're getting away with the regional forms are nice. That's why I love clones. Well, see, I enjoy a good open world game. Like, I don't mind linear games either, because I play JRPGs. I know how to do a linear game. But I also enjoy a good open world too. Like, that's a lot of, I think Genshin's fun to just wander around and explore. Unless it's in Konomiya. In Konomiya, I can shove off. I still need to finish the new together. But, like, Yeah, no, they don't need to be in every game, but for me, the Pokemon games got stale ages ago because it was all the same formula. It was always, okay, here's the bad team, here's the Elite Four, have fun. It's like, I thought it got stale ages ago. Which is why I think I really liked Legends, and I really like, I actually enjoy playing. I've got Phylit. I enjoy just wandering around and doing my own thing. Like, I think it's a lot of fun. Personally, it gives you a lot more options, just because, like, I think Pokemon got boring a while ago. Open world needs purpose. Like, Breath of the Wild, the game exploration was the game, and then Elden Ring just felt empty. Which was the last non-stale Pokemon game you played? Last non-stale? See, okay, I can kind of see what you mean with that. Like, when it is the game. But see, I do think it gives players more options, you know? I still feel like the Gen 4 remix of Gold and Silver was the best. But the last one I played before Phylit was Pokemon Legends. Pokemon Legends I actually really, really enjoyed. Like, I thought it was, like, it didn't look the best, but I really liked it. Because it was something completely different. And that's why I wasn't so sure about Violet and Scarlet. But they did a decent job of making it not feel bad. The last one I played before that was probably Moon, and I don't think I enjoyed that one a whole lot. Because it was the same formula. Like, yeah, Legends was a step in the right direction. It really was. Like, I want more games like that. Where the game is, it's kind of like what Alastair's saying, where the purpose of a more open one. Like, I wish the world was more open like it is in Scarlet and Violet, where it's just like, yeah, if you can get there, have fun. Like, literally, I got to places I should have in no way been in, just because I found a way around, and they're like, okay, sure, have fun. But, like, I like the idea, and then, like, it didn't have, you had to fight the I don't remember what they're called in that game, but, like, you had to fight the thing, the time anomalies, or whatever it was. And stuff, but like in general, like I liked how I know a lot of people didn't like the Pokedex. I really liked the Pokedex, and I liked how it gave you the option of not having to fight everything. You could just throw a Pokeball and see what happens, or you could throw a rock and see what happens. Like, you didn't have to fight. That was nice. Like, I wish they would have kept it where they just throw a Pokeball. And then there were like off games. It's, I don't know, what you call, like, Pokemon Snap a spinoff? I really liked Pokemon Snap as a kid, but playing new Pokemon Snap was great. I really enjoyed that. Or, you know, games that aren't a traditional Pokemon, I guess, is what I've liked for a while. Yeah. Right. It's like, I like when they try things that aren't just, you know, here's the HM badges, here's the Elite Four, here are your bad guys. I really, so, not, Team Star, I guess, is kind of a bad guy. I haven't, let that speak to what it will, but, like, I like how there's not really a set bad guy, quote-unquote, yet, that I know of. But, like, that's nice. And then, yeah, like, Pokemon Snap, it's just, it's something different. It's something, like, you go out there and you're taking pictures. I think that's fun. Or, what's another one that I've played? Okay, so this is going to sound really dumb, but I got really, really into Magikarp Jump. Like, I really liked Magikarp Jump on the phone. I think I beat all of the league. And so I was just on the part, or, like, right after that. But, like, I had so many gold Magikarp. I was so sad when I lost my data for that. I think Pokemon will stay mostly stale if they don't get successful competition, because they really have fun. You don't have to do gyms in every game, for example, to change that part. Right. See, and I think that's why I liked Phylit. You still have the gyms. Like, I don't think the gyms are ever wrong. But I like that it doesn't make you go, okay, here's the grass gym, and here's the electric gym, and then here's the bug gym, and you have to do them in this order. Like, I like that it lets you go and figure out where to go, like, on your own time. And that there are other things to do in the meantime. Like, what? I've got two star bases and a gym left, I think? And a Titan? I have made no progress since the last time I talked about this game. It's been all surprise trading. I really like surprise trading. It's stupid, but it's, I don't know. Anyway. But I like how they give you like the chance to do something different and, you know, more. The gyms are still there, but, and like, I kind of wish they would have leaned into the school aspect again a bit more. Like, I did like that too, how it was like you're going to this school. I didn't like the adults and the kid uniforms, but it's like, I liked that aspect too. Just because it's like, if I'm supposed to be like 10 or whatever, yeah, it makes sense that I'm in a school with a uniform and stuff. So that part, I know a lot of people hated it, but I actually kind of liked it. Pokemon, but with more Persona stuff. Yes. Yes. Give me some of that, like, life sim stuff where you have to balance it. I really like Persona. So to me, it sounds, yeah, I think that would be fun. I think it would be a fun way to change up the Pokemon game. What's this? You have this class and this class? You better study or, you know, look up guides online if you're a cheater like I am. Or, like, what's this? You've got, you know, here's some other options. Here's some other things you can do. You know, have fun figuring it out. Or, like, bonding with friends? Yeah, please. Let me have friends. I am a 10-year-old. I want friends. Like, I think it'd be enjoyable, personally. But I do, like, I've played Golden so many times, it's not funny. I think on my Fida alone, I had 300-400 hours. Like, we could drop gyms entirely and have Pokemon or Team X1 have to take from the leaders. It'd be similar, but the story would be different. Great E. That's true. Like, they could definitely mix up the formula some. Or, like, let's go against a rival school. Like, do it like a school tournament arc. That way you've still got the battles and stuff. But, you know, you have to train your Pokemon up and so on to beat the schools and come out on top of the league. That way. You know? And it's more of a team sport type of thing, I guess. But, you know, instead of football, you know, American football or, you know, tennis or whatever, it's Pokemon battles. And the whole game is just going through the, you know, game trying to get on top of the tournament. That could be a fun change. Can you go away, please? Please. Things are annoying. This is going to be this whole ship. I'm not going to be able to change nozzles. But, you know, like, they can mix it up in a variety of ways. Or, like, give us another game sort of like Legends, because there's obviously some kind of space-time issues going on right now. Let's give us another, you know, another Protag, only in a different era. And honestly, I want them to do more with regionals. Like, if you go to a pet shelter, and you go to look at the cats, you're not going to find all orange tabbies. It's like you're going to have different coat colorations. You know, there are different colors of koi. There are different colors of wolves. You can give us some color variations here, please. Even that will mix it up without having to add new Pokemon every generation. Like, I don't need you to be possessing my... Or cars are no longer a thing. No, we all ride Pokemon now. That was unnecessary. I didn't need a Pokemon bicycle. That's just uncomfortable, in my opinion. On several fronts. What was wrong with a normal bicycle? You know? Give me a car. We can still have electronics. It's okay. Our phone does not have to be a Pokemon. That feels like a very not good idea. Also, like that in Legends, Pokemon were portrayed as dangerous wild monsters. Yeah, honestly. You're relying too hard on the gimmicks, yeah. Yeah. Like, you can change it up. Like, okay, that is one thing. I hate that it's, you know, the phone is possessed by Pokemon. I hate that there are these bicycle Pokemon now. Like, what was wrong with a normal bicycle? This was unnecessary. You could have given me Meowth and four other color combos. Or, you know, give me... Like I said, I got really into Magikarp jump. You could have given me, like, a bunch of different color combos for the Magikarp, you know? make it a little bit more variety like you would find in real life. They don't all have to, you know, you don't have to lean on the gimmicks quite like that. And then, yeah, I absolutely agree with you, what? I really liked how in Legends, they were wild, dangerous creatures. They were not just, you know, a six-year-old walking around. Like, yeah, if you want to talk like pets, like domesticated versus wild. But the fact that between every town, and there's no roads or anything, you all know everyone's doing it. So you always have this, you know, chance of coming across wild Pokemon and getting attacked. Really? Is it Amulet that has all the patterns? Maybe? Magikarp with a Koi pattern. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. I guess it is. But yeah, like, in Magikarp Jump, there were, you know, a bunch of patterns to try to catch. So, I think I got most of them. Like, they had the Orca pattern. They had, like, 3 to 4 different Koi, like, Calico patterns. They had the Golden Magikarp. They had, like... And then, you know... Obviously, after a while, I'd evolve into Gyarados, so you'd have to catch a new Magikarp. But yeah, it's been a lot. 8 building pattern. Really, just they give us that in other Pokemon. We can do that, but like, put it in. Give us like Rockruff. It's this little like wolf dog looking thing. You can give us a couple of different coat patterns, you know. You can give Pikachu more than just the bright yellow, like, give us an orange one, give us one with spots, give us... There are so many possibilities. We don't need to go to... My phone is a Pokemon, and so is my bike. I'm never gonna go with the bike. I hate the bike. The bike drives me insane, can you tell? But... Like, there's a lot of ways to make Pokemon more... exciting, or like different sort of exciting. It doesn't all have to be just like the same. I mean, they do still need highly recognizable designs. Yeah, I mean, you stylize it, but like because of the quality. Yeah. Like, there's a lot, and like, see, I think, like I said, that's why I like the regional forms though. Like, there's what, 3 different Meowth forms now? Because that makes sense. If you go to, you know, New York, and then you go to Paris or whatever, the pigeons are not going to be the exact same. They're going to be mostly the same, but they're not the exact same. Excuse me. And then, like, with Pokemon, it makes even more sense because they have to adapt to the different, like, they can attack with, like, elemental attacks. So it makes sense that, okay, yeah, the one in this region uses this elemental attack. If they did more with that, with like the regional form, I think they'd have something really good going, you know? Where it wouldn't just be, you know, here's a Meowth. Like, no, here's the Galar region Meowth, who is completely different. And, or like, here's the Alolan Vulpix, who doesn't live on a volcano, but on this icy mountaintop. Like, I think that's cool. Regional forms is much better than new Pokemon. Listen, because they are new Pokemon in a lot of time. Yeah! Honestly. Like, it lets you... it would limit the amount of work that... Like, you wouldn't have to come up with, you know, new designs necessarily in the sense of... Okay, what haven't we turned into a Pokemon? We turned our car keys into a Pokemon. Our phone is a Pokemon. Our trash bag's a Pokemon. No, you can take... Oh, here's the cat. And we can turn this into something. Or here's the... You know, here's the rat. Here's the... Kangaroo. Is there a Kangaroo Pokemon? I honestly don't even remember. But like, then there's so many animals that they haven't done yet. That's the other thing. We don't need to make more trash bags because they're running. There's ideas that haven't been done. Yeah, there is a Kangaroo. Okay. Oh yeah, that's like Gen 1. Wow, I feel dumb for forgetting that. But you know what I mean? Like, come up with some different like animals too. Like, I'm sure there are plenty of species you haven't touched. Like, no worries, it's a fairly forgettable one. Okay, because it's like, yeah, no, wait, that's like first generation. That one I should know. But yeah, like when they're sitting there like, oh yeah, your trash is processed now, it also makes you stop and wonder, so how did my trash bag gain sentience again? You wanna tell me that? You wanna tell me how that balloon has sentience? You wanna tell me how these car keys have sentience? rubbish. Best Pokemon this is. Probably just for the meme, honestly. Ooh, are they gonna lean into Mythos more? Like, look, you gave up a long time ago. Why is Pikachu still a mouse Pokemon? They don't know what a mouse is. How do they know what a mouse is? Apparently, normal animals no longer exist in the Pokemon universe, so... They're not gonna... You know, like, lean into more mythical... They've got a few mythical designs. Like, give us more of that, too. Lean on the different mythologies. That's something I really like about, like, Persona games. Is they do the different personas and stuff all have like the different mythologies attached. But like you've got ancient Egypt, you've got Norse mythology, you've got Buddhist, you've got Shinto, you've got Christian mythos in there. You've got like I really like how it's just a bunch of different mythos. It's not like just it's just Buddhist, or it's just, we're going to pull from ancient Egypt, and that's our only gimmick. I really like how it's got the different options, like the different mythologies and stuff. Like, I'm sure Pokemon can find something to do similar. Some kind of. Now, how can we turn this ancient goddess into a Pokemon type of thing? I think it'd be cool to see him try. And definitely more exciting than seeing... I don't even know the name of the... I think it's a fairy type. All I know is it's like a pair, like a bunch of key. And like to this day... Or like the foods? The ice cream one drives me insane. It's like, so what? Did the ice cream get possessed? Yes. That word looks familiar. God. Okay. Isn't there over 1,000 now? True. Don't forget about the gear Pokemon. Oh, God forbid we forget about the gear Pokemon. Yep. True. People who memorize all the Pokemon are amazing. I'm a very simple kitty cat. My brain does not function like that. I can play Persona 5 6 times and still have to look up the answers to the test. Like... I memorized them all back in Platinum. Phew. See, I feel like... Originally, it wasn't too hard. Like, in the first generation and stuff. Especially if you were a anime fan. Because then you could watch, like, Pokemon rap and stuff. But these days, it's like, how? How? But how though? Kitty got small brain. Kitty needs simple. Kitty has one brain cell. Speaking of one brain cell, I'm kind of mad. Either the post delivered it to the wrong spot or someone snagged my mug just that fast. But it said it was delivered a few days ago. And I was like, where's my mug? Where's my mug? Put something in with Throne and with the post. I don't think anything I can do about it. Also, Gen 1 has Electrode. He's an electric ball. They've always had dumb eyes. Right, that's the other thing. When people complain about new designs, it's like, bruh. Go look at the very first generation to tell me some of those designs aren't stupid as hell. Like, Voltorb and Electrode are literally just... out of an electrified Pokeball. Like, I don't know what to tell you, man. They've always had stupid designs. They're just getting really outrageous. Like, I want to know how the ice cream came to life. But otherwise... Also, fun fact, you know how a bunch of shinies suck? Either really ugly or barely a different shade? Yeah. It's why I don't want a shiny Espeon. At the same time, I like how Fortrop and Electric are mistaken for items. It's kind of like a mimic. See that? Yeah, that's true. That's true. Why is the ice cream empty? Like, what do you want from me? What else do you want? See, this is what I mean when I say it's either really generous or it's really annoying. There's way too much dirt for it to give me an answer otherwise. Yeah, ice cream cones are a weird choice. But anyway, yeah, I know what you mean about the shinies. So many ugly green shinies. Yes! They originally designed shinies randomly. Algorithm. The only ones aren't designed on purpose. Oh, seriously? And they still put those ugly designs in. I hate some of the shiny colors so much. Some of them, really nice. Really cool. Some of them were like, what were you thinking? I recall my first shiny found in Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon. Such a hideous Pokemon. Ooh, oof. Oof. Shinies are... My first was a Ponyta. Okay, so I don't remember what my first shiny is, because admittedly I've never been big on like shiny hunting or anything either. But I did find a shiny Pokemon in Legends, like super early in. Like in like the first region you unlock. You know where the mad Rapidash is? The one that's like a pain in the butt and will curb stomp you if you go and find it when you're just starting? Yeah. Yeah, that's... I found a blue Ponyta over there, like, almost immediately. I loved it. It was my child. Somehow the... I think it was about... What? Right afterwards I found the Rapidash on me, and it's like, run, run, run. But yeah, that was my first shiny. I think it's... Was it the... I think it might be a quest or something, yeah. But, and then what, I saw a shiny, was it a Ralts? No. What's the one that, Curlia? It was a shiny Curlia that I really liked too. I like how the shiny Diglets just have blue moves. Some of the shinies are ridiculous. I think my first shiny other than Gyarados 2 was Drowsy. Mm-hmm. Like I said, I don't think I've ever actually on shiny hunting or anything like that, so I don't remember most of mine. I do know I really want a shiny Eevee though. I don't know why, but I really, really like the silver Eevee. Especially, like, if you think about it, shinies in no way should have survived in the wild. What was it? I read something about it, like, comparing it to, like, albino Pokemon or albinism. Like, out in the wild, so it's like, if it looks different, it's like, there's no way you should have survived this long. That's fascinating, because if you think about it that way, it's like, yeah, no, you shouldn't have made it this far. The fact that you have is brilliant. You are a strong soul. But anyway, so I want a shiny Eevee. I mean, it doesn't really compare to albinos. Like, not in like the most technical sense. So if you want to get down into like the genetics of it, it's not going to compare, you know, obviously. But it's like, if you see something that is normally a dark-colored animal and they're light-colored, logically, their chances of survival are so, so much lower. And to really, like, simplify it, it makes an amount of sense to compare a shiny to that. Because it's like, if I'm in a region that's being... Albino actually harmful effects, just being green wouldn't do that. No. Like I said, in terms of like genetics, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. It's very much surface level like coloration stuff. But they're basically like albino rodents where they are bred by humans. Yeah, like in terms of like actual genetic stuff, it's not gonna be like a good case, but it would be case by case at best. Yeah, but can we really compare Pokemon in general to the real world? Most of Pokemon doesn't make sense if you really want to get, like, a mouse that can generate electricity. Like, we lost semblance of reality a while ago. I'm also about to just give up because I don't think this is going to ding on me right now. Please, I've gone back and forth how many times? Why are you not done yet? What else do you want from me? Okay, time to move on. We're doing the white section now. We're just gonna take us... It's gonna take us like an hour to get just the white section done, I guarantee it. We'll do the red while we're here too. Look, we're gonna be here. Well, maybe the keel will decide it will be done at some point in the near future. That'd be nice. But anyway, yeah, like, in terms of, like, actual, like, genetics, it in no way makes a good comparison. But, like, just on a surface level, like, coloration, how are you surviving in your situation thing? It's like, yeah, okay, but there's just a speck in a crease somewhere. I hate this game sometimes. It is. It's, like, either super, super, like, generous, you can have a whole patch of dirt left, and it's like, yeah, no, this is fine. Or it's like, look, we're just going to sit here and be like, no, you have to find this one speck, or we're not changing. Maybe an electromicer evolution to attack the wall of foam snibbling or something. You know what? That's the other thing, like, I want to know what happened to, like animals in that world. I remember it was Ocarus that mutated everything, at least in... Okay, I don't know my Pokemon lore. We need to go deep dive Pokemon lore. Change this to just looking at Pokemon stuff. we can pull up a Windows tab and go looking. That could be a... Maybe I'll do that tomorrow. I'm out of Genshin stuff to do again. As a fire is, your Pokemon can get incredibly rarely. It gives an XP boost. And it's contagious. Oh, we need to shut down and... That sounds like something that would be fun to sit down and actually, like, walk through. Because it's, admittedly, I don't know a whole lot of stuff, and it's been a while. I guess it's also been weird, and I've never been one to go for, like, oh yeah, this one, I need the perfect specs on this before. Like, no, you're cute, you hit hard, let's go. And explore X. Did that? All faster. I'm trying to spread Pokerus to a few Pokemon I never use so I can spread around my whole party. Ooh, that's nice. I think Game Theory did a video on it. Oh, probably. That sounds like something MatPat would do. That sounds like a Game Theory. I wouldn't be surprised. Let's see, what do I want to do tomorrow? Do I want to do a Genshin exploration and just do another glorified just chatting, or... We can stop and deep dive Pokemon. Get into theories. I really want to do, like, just a stream that's just, like, theory talk. Like, really bad. What's more interesting is how they use Mary Pokemon. I do remember seeing theory. I remember seeing that, and I remember going, Or like the Nurse Joy one. Which, I mean, makes a strange amount of sense if you stop to... Not even theory that was in the book. Oh my god. Pokemon is insane. That's what I'm getting. That's all it comes down to. Do we want to get into this? Do I want to get into Pokemon? All of a sudden, I'm re-questioning this. Do I really want to get into this? Wait. Yeah, it's just a cute children's game about catching, you know, pocket monsters. No. Pokemon marriage. There's gods and there's so much. There's so much. This hole is so much deeper than I realized. But. Could be interesting. Considering there's places people can marry someone. You know. Just because it's true doesn't mean we have to acknowledge. There's. Do we want to get into moral cult? No, we probably don't. This is not the time or the place for that would be a fun thing to do, too. Like, let's just go find the weirdest laws we can find. Read about them, discuss them. anybody wants to talk about it, let's go. But yeah, I feel like that would be just fun. Sit there and look up the stuff and read about it and so on. Like I said, I really want to do a... I think it made more sense in context. It's okay, so that's something I just definitely want to look at it to see what's actually going on. See like what the situation is. Because like situationally maybe. But that's definitely gonna be we need to sit down and figure out what's going on. Because in general, it sounds very like I can't imagine weird legal purpose for it. Yeah, it's like I said, I feel like that one might be it's situational, case by case. Let's sit down and think about this, looking at it from certain viewpoints type of. It's very much one that you'd want to stop and look at and consider otherwise, I think. What I'm hearing is... Okay, so fun fact. Recently, I went ahead and I made a FOD channel. And there's not much on it right now. Right now, it's just more stuff. But I want to start doing, like, when I start, like, an RPG from the beginning, uploading it onto there. Anyway, so I made that channel. I also want to start doing like edited stuff, like edited FODs maybe, and like clips and highlights. But I do want to do some more scripted type of stuff. I feel like this would be an interesting place to stop. And there's people who marry serial killers during trials, which is blatantly weird. Okay, yeah, no, those people I have no desire to understand. Oh, this person just killed like 20 people? Ooh, talk about sex. Like, no. Those people I have no desire to understand. But, like, sitting down to, like, talk about this type of stuff. And, like, I don't know, maybe in a podcast sort of format, which I guess is kind of what, like, when we do, like, glorified just chattings. That's the type of thing that is more kind of, like, but in a more purposeful, you know, way. In a way that's semi-scripted, where you can go off script a bit, but, like, you also have your talking points and stuff. I kind of want to try doing something like that, and I don't know how it's going to go, but like, you'll never know if you don't try, right? Yeah, it was 10 buddy, I had to try. I think it's happened more than once. People marry people in jail all the time, and it's like, why though? Like, if you're in there for like something stupid, like a marijuana charge, okay, well that's just fucking dumb. That's, yeah, go marry your sweetheart, whatever. But like, when it's someone like a serial killer, it's... Ted Bundy is a fascinating case study, honestly. Just in general, and I don't think I want to understand it. Like, and then there was, like, with the movies and stuff, it's... I don't know. Why would you make a lot of that? Oh, every time there's a trial, they get fangirls. It's ridiculous. Yeah, no, that's, like, what? Or, like, it's not on the side of TikTok I'm on, but I see people complain about the side of TikTok where they're, like, serial killer fans and stuff. It's like, See, there's a different, like, if you're a fan of a fictional killer, it's like, okay, yeah, you know, everyone's got that's different. Like, liking a villain is one thing, but when it's reality and people are like, oh yeah, serial killing's so hot, like, no, what's wrong with you? Please go see a therapist. Humans are weird. They really are. I've been around humans for a very long time. I'm no closer to understanding them. I now have a human form, and it's not helping me any. It's helped with the taste, but it's like, I understand, you know, why people like certain foods and stuff now. But, like, actually understanding how the brain... No. No. No, thank you. Humanity as a whole is just a very, very confusing, messy... thing. I don't even know what to call it.
something all right.
In lighter news, I just found an image of Dwayne the retro. You know, that doesn't even surprise me. It is very funny though. That's we all need to practice our puns. He wants to become a pun master with me. I don't know why people say puns are lowbrow humor. I think they're fascinating. Like, actually, like, they take a whole lot more, like, wit than people seem to give credit to. Puns are fun. Me! Puns are fun. Yes. We've got to practice and become pun masters. Let's go. Yeah, when people go, yeah, no, they're the, you know, the lowest form of humor. She's like, no, they're not. That's actually, like, you have to be clever. You have to be, you know, witty to be able to go and connect to things like that. Like, some of them are, like, you know, stupid. But, like, other ones are, like, no, that's going to take some brilliance. Now, the lowest humor. The lowest form of humor is short. There. Okay. Humor, I understand humor subjective. I don't understand why people find fart jokes so funny. I know I'm the weird one when it comes to that, but it's like, but why though? I've never been big on toilet. Like, they're still good. Very down to earth. Look, you don't even have to. You've already gone down. Let's go. Maybe that's what I'll do. I'll do just a stream. I've legitimately got a book called The Pun Also Rises. That's like about like the history and of like some of the psychology and stuff behind puns. I haven't finished it, but it's surprisingly good. We can just do it as streamers, just reading about puns. Maybe that will be my first edited video. I'll just read a book. Yeah. But yeah, like, people who can come up with, like that alabaster, like, that's really, actually really clever. Like, when you can sit there and they seem simple, and it's like, no, that takes some, you know, you have to be able to, one, there's the context clues and stuff, and to be able to make the connection and put them together and stuff. I don't understand why people think those are brilliant. Like, you have to stop and think about it and make these connections and stuff. Really smart. And it deserves more credit. But anyway. But yeah, I really admire people who are good at, like that alabaster. Like, that's clever. It's cute. Like, my players fought a group of dire bears. The puns were nonstop. Ayy. I really need to. I want to do. Like I said, I was invited to do like a TTRPG type of thing. And I really need to stop and like look at the different types there are and how to get in. The wizard flying above, throwing fire, shouting, bear. Fair game. Look, if you're putting up, you know, if you're going to put them against something that is very easily, you know, very easily, that's the type of thing. Yeah. You see the easy joke, you run with it. A meow for this idea. Okay, so Mizu sent me like a list of cat puns. I need to get them memorized and figure out what types of situations. See, it's all about including it in your everyday vocabulary. I had to come up with a half one you see on the spot. Okay, so that just makes you a good DM. Like, if you're able to stop and come up with characters and go, okay, yeah, this is definitely how this works and stuff. Like, that just makes you a good DM. I also asked his name, so I came up with Shire Bottle. Is Shire now beloved by all? No, Kenny Twist, why would you do that? It's okay, this game isn't like, I'm not fighting anything. You're just gonna make it 20 times more difficult when I have to go over everything again. So if I miss any spots, nobody can get mad at me because it's literally all just my eyesight's stuck. I apologize, chat. I can no longer see. I see colors. Like, I know by looking at the colors, Cadrus made a comment. I couldn't tell you what it says, though. Thank you for the head fat. I need it. I don't even remember how long I made this last. How long is this supposed to be good for? Wait. Oh, no. Oh, this is about to become a very one-sided conversation. What do we want to talk about? Hopefully y'all are staying hydrated. We're being nice and, you know, cozy and keeping... Depending on the weather. I know weather's been, like, freezing for some people. So hopefully you're staying warm if it's freezing. And you don't get sick. And you don't get the sniffles. But once again, I can't see what you're saying. I just know. I see the colors. There's, like, pink. And the purple. I know it's Cadrus. Does it say Lumi just donated to the totem? Thank you for that. Okay. All the bottoms are spread across a very prolific area. It'll look clean even if it's not. You know what? Someone bullied the Saywex. Someone bullied. Yeah. We don't know who, though. No idea who could have done it. Just someone. There's okay, look, it's either we stop and it's just gonna be me squinting at chat very close to my computer screen, or chat's gonna have to wait because I can't see. It's very much we're going based on colors. I know Alabaster said something, and I see Lumi said something a couple of times. So do I want to give the idea? Do I want to? No, I probably should. That's spelling my own demise. I'm gonna say now's the time to. If you're gonna do any throw purchases, I'm not gonna see it. But. So, how are you doing, Lumi? I hope you're having a good Saturday. Hopefully it's okay. We were talking about random stuff. There was a lot of Pokemon. I think you missed most of that. I see. Green. That was a VIP. Who else just... What? Chance? Hi, I think that's Chance. Hi, Chance. I can't see you, so... apologies, chat. I'm extremely nearsighted. Like, this isn't even a joke. I took off my glasses for that. I cannot see what's being said right now. So. How long did I make this? I don't remember how long this redeem is. It's not over yet, though. Ugh. And of course we're doing this. Why is this still black? You're still black, and I don't want that color anymore. I want you to... All those little barnacles or whatever they are need to come off. We are gonna spend 5 minutes just catching what you're all are saying. You're all better not be talking trash about me. Nah, I deserve you. Is it over? Okay. Nope, no trash here.
Look.
Stay hydrated.
I'll draw the spirit. Have to double check, make sure.
No, I just got some. Why is. Hi. Camera, are we good? Are we okay? Yes? Okay. No, it's good. Just trying to finish Lantern Rite in one day. Have you done the story or is it all the minigames? The minigames aren't too bad. I think they're kind of fun, actually. The story only takes a few hours. The story is surprisingly.
They had to double check as well.
Don't worry, we can play more Power Wash tomorrow. If anyone wants to join me in PC, let me know.
Can't take it. I'm so nearsighted. I probably worse.
Yeah, just finished the whole story. That took all morning. It's a good story though, isn't it? Okay, so what bothers me about the Lantern Rite story is we are still missing information. Like, what was going on with Yelan? I want that explained because we didn't actually get that explained very well. But otherwise, I think the Lantern Rite story was really good this year. Like, I felt so bad for Shell. Like Yelan said, we don't need to know. Look, you don't show that in the cutscene and then, like, just take the credit. There was... Look. There was something going on and I want to know. It ended with her walking off at the end. Right? What was she doing? What was going on? I don't know. I want to, though. Like, yeah, she just... Someone came up to her and she ends up walking off. What do you mean we don't need to know? I feel like this is very important to know, actually. Because if it's distracting late Yelan like that, something's going on. But yeah, like, oh, the ending was really good, though. With, like, Shell. It's no big... It's crucial. Like, with, Hu Chao knows so much. Look. Okay, you know Danganronpa, right? Yes. What about it? Remember, she's clean up behind the scenes. Nothing important. Wait, why'd you bring up Danganronpa? Where are we going with this? The whole discussion at the dinner table was... Oh my god, it was, wasn't it? Look, okay. You cannot tell me. Hu Chao definitely knows about Chongli, and she probably has her suspicions about Fenty. Let's be real. She knows about Chongli. You can't tell me she doesn't. No. I actually want to play that game. Like, I... it's been so long. Since I watched someone do a fan translation of it, and it was really good. But I'm sad no Chi-Chi this Lantern Rite. We got some Chi-Chi. Like, it wasn't much, but we got a little bit of Chi-Chi with Baizu. And Yao Yao says she sees her best friend, which is... Okay, I found the link for breath restoration. Let it be harder. Worth checking out at least. Ooh, okay, yeah. Look, I'm definitely gonna do more visual novels. I really want to do Hustle Cat, just because Hustle Cat's cute. But I want to do some more, too. Yao Yao is so cute. Yao Yao was precious. Yao Yao versus Minyao battle for Chi-Chi. Love Hustle Cat. Like I said, I think I've only ever gotten Finley, but I want to go and actually play and get some of the other ending. Because Hustle Cat is so cute. And I really like what Hustle Cat does. It's like they give you the option to choose a little bit of like the player design and like adding the pronouns and stuff, which I think is just a really nice touch. So like, you don't have to be like a female protag. You can do, you know, she, her, he, him, they, them. Like, they give us the options, and it's really nice. Same. Yeah. And then, yeah, you can, like, edit what they look like and stuff, and it's just nice. It's a nice way to mix up the visual novel. I just know with Hustle Cat, I would get really, like, y'all, I would have to have somebody else to do it with me. because y'all saw me struggling with three characters. Wait, I could hold together a whole cast. I tried that with Ben in theater. We saw how that went. Fucking Ben in theater. Such a cute. Anyway. I also want to do, are you allowed to stream Clannad? Because I have Clannad and I've never played it. But I think I read somewhere that you weren't allowed to stream it. I don't remember. I was wondering why I couldn't join the Discord and I remembered you're in the Yeah. There should be a link somewhere. Or, I don't know if exclamation point Discord's actually gonna work. Half my stuff works, half of it doesn't, and I don't know what's what most of the time. That work? Yeah. Yeah, I share it with Lenny. And Do and Pim. Yeah. And just because... Oh, I joined a long time ago when I met Pim. Good choice. I just stretched, but it's like, stretch again. I follow the whole group. Well, thank you. I appreciate it. And I'm glad you're here spending some of your Saturday with me. I really do appreciate it. Just here talking about random stuff. I'm gonna have the Bad in Theater song in my head now. I need to do... I fucked up. We could have done karaoke today. None of the songs would have been ready or anything like that. Because I didn't realize I was going to be, you know... They could have been karaoke. It would have been perfect. The kid is, like, an hour and a half away at a thing. The, you know... Middle brother's at work. Younger brother's with the kid. Like, I could have done karaoke. Oh, fuck. Okay, I'm gonna have to try to... I'm actually mad about that now that I've realized it. Because I still owe everyone a karaoke stream. Okay, you guys need to start suggesting karaoke songs. Put them in Discord. Or I got me hooked on VTubers and now I'm everyone's problem. Yeah. Mari is definitely someone who's well worth it, though. Like, I love her. And... She's definitely, like, she's going places right now. I love it. Like, her new outfit, so good. Blessed be Maru. I'm also very biased with Maru, but, like, whatever, it's fine. Maru does good work. They do. I love it. I think Maru's probably falling asleep by now. So, I can guess all I want. Speaking of Maru, I need to see if I can bug them into giving me a time because we were playing around with something for Mori and it's like, ooh. One day when I get the money to, I'm going to commission Maru too. Yes, do it. They do all sorts of fun things. They do illustrations, they do reference sheets, they do models. They're like, you just want an icon even. And then we've got Lumi's an artist, but I don't think Lumi really does commissions except special circumstances. Like, I've got... That's what I should do. I need to restart Dot Hack. Because I've got a Grunty PNG from Lumi, and it's so cute. I haven't played Dot Hack in so long. Right now, I'm trying to get started with a Euro PNG. Hey, hell yeah, let's go. Euros work so good, too. Oh. If I didn't work full-time, I'd be making so much for art. You gotta put your spoons where you need them. So, do your artwork when you want to do your artwork. Do your... Like, don't let work burn you out, though. But, heck, yeah, I started... Like, I had started, GU, and then I... Then I wanted to grind off stream, and then I just went back to it. I'm probably, if I do that, I'm gonna... Like I said, I got this really cute Grunty PNG from Lumi, though. I want to get combs when I'm saving for something more important. Fair enough. Combs are expensive. Especially once you start, like, if you know artists and start looking and stuff. That Grunty was so much fun to make. I'm glad. My first time making one. Gee, I'm glad you liked it. Came out really cute. You guys want to see my Grunty? It's really cute. Ah, the people say like so actually. Look, Axel. Look. Sure. Okay. So what I'm hearing is I need to restart that. Like, part of it can be with a model, and then part of it can be with the Grunty. Because look at my Grunty, it is adorable. Not looking forward to being work and streaming. I deliver mail, so it's 8:35 or later. Oh, cool. Work with the post? That's a respectable job. That's about my work schedule too, TBH. Only the thing is, I work from home. Anyway. let's see. Oh, there you are. Grunty! Look how cute this is. Look how cute this is! I mean, I'm doing basically what I'm doing. Just adding the life part. There's Grunty! Isn't it so cute? I love the Grunty! There she is! Yeah, yeah. Cool. I love the Grunty art that Lumi did. Look how cute! Hello, cool Grunty. Yeah. So I really need to get back into Dot Hack. Like, she's just sitting there. She's not getting used properly. And like I said, I know part of it I'm going to be doing with a model anyway, like live 2D, but then like, look, Grunty, I need to use her. I need to show her off. I need to actually go back and either restart or actually grind, but then the story is gonna be lost and it's been so long, so I might as well just restart at this point. If I do that, then I can transfer the fallout over. Anyway. Yeah. But yeah, we need to do Dot Hack some more. Get her some use. I'd do the older ones, because the older ones are more easily accessible, but I've played GU before technically, but it's been a long time. I played it back on like PlayStation 2. One day hope for the Salix Field. Keep hoping, Chance. Unless you buy it yourself, it ain't happening. I'm gonna have to emulate the older ones. Yeah, I know. That's what sucks, is I've never really messed with emulation before, so I don't know how difficult it is, but I've considered it a few times. Like, I know Axel is playing through them and stuff, because I had set in on those streams, but I've never actually messed with them. And it does kind of suck that GU, like, I really like GU because GU is where I started with Dot Hack. I mean, I guess Legend of the Twilight technically is where I started, because I'd watch that, like, Dot Hack 9 on Toonami at, like, 5 in the morning. But technically, I've been a Dot Hack fan since I was young, like, young. But when it comes to the games, GU's where I started. So I really like GU, and I'm glad GU got redone 3 different times. But I do wish it was easier to play the older game. And I'm at the icky part of Dot Hack, where it's just power score grinding. GU doesn't need grinding fortunately. It wouldn't let me type Dot Hack because it thought it was a command. Oh jeez. Whoop. But yeah. I definitely want to at least go back and finish what I started with GU. Like, restart it, but finish what I started if I need to. And then we'll see if I decide to try to emulate. If I do, Axel, I'll definitely have to hit you up, though, because... But I had one of the games because I read the manga. I don't remember which it was, and I didn't have... had trouble, didn't get into it much. Honestly, that's fair. I don't know what it was about GU, but I think I might have been on Tumblr and I saw something and I'm like, okay, now I'm curious or something like that. Or I got into it around the same time as a friend, but the HD gives faster walking speed, more inventory, so it was fun doing 100. Yeah, like, I do. I need to actually sit down and, like, get into it. Because I enjoyed it, what I had done. And then it was just, like, I got to the arena. And, okay, I'll come back to Enter the Room. So at this point in time, I might as well be. And then, like I said, at least that way I could export the FODs out to YouTube or whatever. And then anybody who's, like, new and wants to get into it and hear the story with me. Do I want to do cheat mode? I don't think I had it on cheat mode, but I feel like cheat mode would make it too easy, you know? Which is why I didn't do it. I do like that they give people the option, though. Once you just want to get to the fourth story, fuck Ovan. I will die on this hill, fuck Ovan, and fuck Shino. But... Ovan deserved so much worse than he got. I am passionate about this. I will die on this hill. If you need a hand or company, you got my support. Yay. Yes, yes, yes. All the dot hack fun. But yeah, I feel like it's a series that I want to get more people into. Like, if they haven't done it. Even if it is just, like, starting with G. But... because I really like G. Certified member of the hate club. Yes, absolutely. Fuck Ovan. He deserves so much worse than he got. KK Slide. I've got game chops on right now. Dude, no joke. I've considered getting fan art of me as Haseo and someone idolizes this one. No, because hopefully if you idolize them, they treat you better than that. You deserve better than that, Axel. Do not let anybody treat you the way Ovan treated Haseo. I was so... look, you can tell I'm still mad about this. It has been years since I finished those games. Years! And I'm still so mad about, like, I'm getting heated now. Fuck Ovan. Love your... yes! You deserve so much better than this. If you, any of you have an Ovan in your life, cut them out. You deserve better. It's okay, sweetie. I know it will hurt. And it's gonna be hard. But you can do it. I believe in you. Fuck Ovan. And fuck Shino too. Like, God. She pissed me off when... like, the way she idolized Ovan, and that's what got Haseo in the first... no. No, y'all were playing with Haseo so bad. That boy did not deserve your bullshit. Adelaide, like, and okay, I couldn't even... so Adelaide deserved better too? Like... but like, Adelaide deserved better too, but like at the same time, I couldn't even be mad with the how... I think I'd actually... when we first got to that point, me and my one friend, we both got to the point with Adelaide and Haseo in that one fight that they have. And it's like, look, he was kind of a jackass about it, but he's not wrong. It's just the visual aspect. They have a darker complexion of blue hair and barriers. Like, if you want to do it visually, I guess. Guess it's like the character I have massive hate for is Mignetta, but like, please have a purpose besides harassing people. Thanks. Okay, I need to get back into Hero Aka. I fell off a while ago, but yeah, like, same. Like, from the start, he drove me insane. Like, why are you here? Who let you into this class? Who let you in? Is it just because you have a quirk that's visible? Like, bruh, no. Hasn't gotten better yet. Seriously, all this time, and he's still in the hero class. Oh my god. Bruh. There are so many other people that could have been in the hero class, but no, they didn't have visible quirks. Like, bitch. But you let the you know, serial sexual harasser in without disciplining him. Okay, sure. There's some things we can say about the hero. Ugh. Look, we're not talking about Bakugo because I can't and won't go on that rant too. Like,
what is it, first manga volume, first episode, he literally tells Deku to jump off the roof. No, he is a serial abuser. Fuck off with Bakugo.
Oh, but he gets better. And it's like, no, I don't fucking care.
Just because he gets better eventually doesn't mean he doesn't owe Deku for years and years of abuse. Like, you can't be a hero with that type of attitude. I'm just... look. Then again, Endeavor got away with it, didn't he? Okay, hi. Bruh, nothing gets me more heated than sexual harassment used for cheap laughs. Honestly. Okay, so in some of the older stuff, like, I don't think it was super funny then either, but at least it made a little bit more sense with the society at that point in time. Like, what? I know Ranma was one of the first animes that I watched, like, when it came to, like, anime. Not, like, Pokemon and Game Tower and stuff, but, like, actual anime. Very first was Haruhi. Haruhi deserves the world. But, like, okay, so, like, Hapusai, not a funny character. I don't particularly like him, but considering when Ranma was made, I can forgive that a little bit more. When Hiroaka was made, Mineta, there was no excuse for Mineta. Absolutely not. Like, why is he a character in this story about heroes? We're supposed to be focusing on these good guys. The ones who are literally going out and, like, being paid to save lives and stuff. Why are you putting so much focus, and especially with, like, Deku as the main character, why are you putting so much focus on this character who does nothing but, like, harass the girls? Like, how is that funny? Just because he's a teenager doesn't make it okay. Teenagers being teenagers, like, yeah, if they want to talk, you know, having a couple of scenes every once in a blue moon, maybe? Where it's like, okay, yeah, you know, they want to peep on the girls. Not particularly funny, but, like, in context, it makes sense. They're teenagers. But when that's your whole defining character trait is, hey, I want to grab some boobies. No, that's not funny. That's not funny. That's not... hopefully it's not super realistic. Like, admittedly, I've never... I'm also kind of a gray A, so it's like hit or miss. I can appreciate aesthetics, but it's hit or miss on other stuff. But it's still like, hopefully most teenagers are going around and all they're thinking about is like, let's grab some butts, let's grab some boobs, let's grab, you know, let's harass and make our classmates super uncomfortable and unhappy. And like, it's just, it's not funny. Like, when that's your main, and then he's like a huge crybaby. Like, how are you? Why do you want to be in the hero class if you don't want to do anything heroic? It's like fighting tooth and nail to get you to do anything actually useful. Why are you in this class? Go to the gen class. Let someone who actually wants to work for it and, you know, put in the effort and have the smarts for it be in this class. You being here just because, honestly, how did it get past the physical aspect of the hero class test? Was bullshit anyway. Like, that's so rigged. But like, how did he get past that? How did he get enough points to get in that class? His work sucks too. Yes! Like, how did he get past that? Like, bruh. Okay guys, he found his resolve to be a hero so he can get girls. Doesn't excuse it, but the West is definitely ahead in writing more comfortable characters. Yeah, I mean, that's true, I guess. Like, you're not wrong, Lumi. But it's still, if they want to put it like in context of the universe even, how did he get in with that quirk? He shouldn't have been able to get past, like, between his attitude with like heroing and stuff, like, he's a coward. And there's nothing wrong with being afraid and stuff, but when your literal job is to go into dangerous situations to save other people, and all he wants to do is cry and hide and make other people do the work. How did he get into this class where they are training your literal job being jumping into danger? And like, I don't understand. I really don't know what the writer got out of that character though. Honestly, it's like, like I said, I fell off of Hiroaka a while ago and I do kind of want to get back into it just to like check it out again, because I really liked it for a while. But it's like, It's like the very first thing at the training simulating place, and all he wanted to do was cry and be a pervert. Like, are you kidding me? That's as someone who likes writing jerks. Yeah. Like, I don't know. Like, if he had some redeeming character traits, it'd be different. But isn't he the author self? So it's a bigger one. My bad mouth. I mean, dang, if so, that's on, isn't it? Because yeah, if that's how the author sees himself, like, the author, bruh, go to therapy. I know Japan's got like some stigma against it, but like, please, you can afford it. Go to therapy. Just saying. Oh, Dev. So, now that I've sat here in bad mouths, I'll throw your back on. Simon, you're not stop. Get some help. Please. And while you're at it, leave the class and let someone else move up. I can't remember his name right off the top of my head. It's admittedly been a hot minute. But the one guy who can literally control people with his voice. Let him be in the hero class. He obviously wants it awfully bad. He would be, you know, he'd put the work into it. He would put the effort into it. He's not a fucking coward. He's not a serial harasser. Let that kid in. Christ. At least the favorite grinding. Man, my dude, my guy. Please stop. Stop. And consider why you like this character so much. And if the answer is because he's self-insert, please go get some help. Especially since you're writing about teenagers. If that's how you were as a teenager, I have some other concerns. I'm just saying. Like, there are some other issues here. Ugh. Vignetta's an awful character. Awful character, awful quirk, awful personality. Nothing redeeming. There are certain hills I will die on, and this is apparently one of them. No, I will not apologize. Anyway. I think that's about as good. Are you actually gonna ding? Apparently that still hasn't. I don't know why. Well, if I've never watched My Hero Aka, but I know about how Trashman is to France. Okay, that should tell you something right there. If you've never seen the show and you still know how bad a character is because people will go off on it, that should tell you it is a bad fucking character. Like he's not a good character in general. He has zero redeeming traits. He's not brilliant. His quirk is awful. His quirk is he's got sticky hair. He's got sticky balls. How is that, you know, useful for this job? You know, he serial harasses his classmates, you know, grabbing at their chests and their butts every time they get the chance. Like, he's always trying to peep. He's always trying to, like, be a perv. He's not a good character. Like, even if him harassing everyone wasn't as bad as it was, it'd still be bad because it's his only truth. Yeah! And then he's a coward. He will sit there and cry and try to hide and make other people do all the work. Your literal job in the future is to be a hero. That means you go into dangerous situations on purpose. I hate him. Oh, God. He's got sticky ones. Okay, look. I think, isn't that literally how he describes his trait at one point in time? Oh, but he's brave because he fights his fear. No, like, you want to know who fights his fear? Deku. Deku is brave because he fights his fear. Mineta is a whiny little bitch and gets drug out by his ears. He doesn't do it willingly. Yeah, being brave is having the courage to do a thing even if you're afraid. Mineta isn't brave. He is a fucking coward. He is drug out by other people. Like, I like Deku when he uses his lore knowledge. That's my favorite part. Yeah, like, okay, so, like I said, I've kind of fallen off, so I don't know if they make him dumber or anything, but I do like how early in, that was his, like, before he, you know, could control the quirk, he should have been allowed in the hero course, just based on that. He could figure that shit out. He hasn't done it as much. That's a shame, because that was a really nice character trait. Deku was a very smart, very, like, very smart boy. Very clever, very, like, observant. And, like, if they had just put the effort into giving him some good equipment, he could have kicked ass without a quirk. He did not need to have superpowers. And I think that's, ugh, like, he deserved better. I've read, what's the name of the one that I really liked? I don't think it was ever completed. I think it might have been abandoned, but, what's it called? What was it called? Erased Potential? Is that the one I'm thinking of? Where Eraserhead takes and kind of mentors Deku before, like, before All Might can find him, to turn him into a hero without the fucking magic hair or whatever. I don't know. The whole thing could have been much better. The power scaling made it not be as much. God, I love Shonen with insane power scaling. I feel like for Hero Aka, they didn't even need the power scale. Honestly, they could have done it without doing power scaling at all. That's the type of show, like, it takes place at a hero school. Like, a school for, in a world where everybody has magic powers, except for the unlucky few. They didn't need the power scale. They could have done so much with, like, more what's the word I'm looking for? Like, were they, rational. But, like, where they approach it using, like, logic and, like, observations and stuff like that. He does use it to be creative with his own ability. I mean, that's fair. Like, how early for was. I mean, yeah, if you're using it to make your power, you know, stronger, like, that's fair. But, like, early fairy tale, Natsu was smart about his power. Yeah, like, I feel like that's, it could have been so much more. And I think that's, I think I fell off because I do want to go back, but it is. It's like, you make the characters clever. Make them have to think about what they're doing. Make them, you don't have to make every few arcs, let's get a power upgrade. No, you can use the powers you've got. Just make it where you have to think about it in more creative ways. Not one of them for a few arcs. Yeah, the universe and powers were nice. I prefer creative complex instead of just using the universe. Yeah. Like, the concept is brilliant, honestly. Like, where Hero, what is it? The boys? I haven't watched it, but I think that's what it's called. But heroes are, you know, a paid profession. You've got so much creatively you could do with that. And if you're going to be focusing on kids going to school, it's basically a vocational school, right? They're going and learning these traits before they leave high school so that they can get, like, certificates or whatever and then go on to other places to get more of the technical skills or whatever and then learn more about it. So it's like it could be approached like a vocational school, and they could have definitely done something where it's just, you know, clever outcomes, or like where they still learn new ways to use the power. So it's better than that. But that's fair, I guess. I just wish that they would have put more on not power scaling. Like, I know Deku got a new ability every couple of arcs, and it's like, that was unnecessary. That was, you could have just given him, you know, the super strength or whatever in a couple of them, and left it at that and made it where, okay, how can I use this? Like, he didn't need new powers every time he did. And yeah, with the power scaling and the fill-ins and stuff, it's like, I mean, I get it, but at the same time, it's good that they're still, like, learning how to, like, put the abilities to new tests and stuff, though. Give it at least some semblance of, let's think this through. Well, that's good. But, yeah. I just want something creative. I want something different. And I can't, that's why I don't get into shonen super often. Because it's like, it will start off really good, and then it will just turn into a, okay, who can smack, like, who can hit harder? How do I make it where I hit harder? And it's like, you don't take these clever characters and then make them dumb. Like, at least with Slice of Life, I know it's going to be like, okay, you know, if I wanted something moe, it's just like cute girls doing cute things. Okay, well, at least I'm going in knowing that's what I'm getting. Ochi the Rock's a really good show, by the way, y'all should watch. Or like, it's the same with like romance anime and stuff. Like, where they're sitting there, and if it's the same thing every time, it's the same argument we had about Pokemon earlier. It gets stale when it's the same thing all the time. Give us something new, give us something different. You can take a similar formula and then put a twist on it. If I'm making cookies, I'll add more vanilla to it because I like more vanilla, and it makes them different from, you know, the neighbor next door. Like, bruh, please. Give us something. Power creep sells issues. Yeah. It ain't that just the way. Ugh. Yeah. Go watch Pochi the Rock. Go watch Horimiya. Horimiya's really good. Ugh. Yeah, like I said, I think that's just, it's why I kind of get bored with shonen so fast. Because it does, it just turns into power creep. Like, I've never been big on, Dragon Ball. I got bored of Naruto. I got bored of Bleach. Like, I really liked Bleach and then, okay, I'm bored. Like, I got bored of Inuyasha. Like, I start off really liking the concept and the story and stuff. And then it gets to the point where it's like, okay. Come on now. This is unnecessary. Or, like, I know, like, they drag it out because it sells more. And the more they sell, you know. Oh, now you're done. Okay, thank you. I hate this game sometimes. Anyway, like, they drag out the fights and the beating the big bad and stuff. Because the more issues they put out, the more money they make. But it still kind of sucks when a story can be wrapped up so much faster than it is because they want to make the money. Like, you could have finished that story so much smoother. This could have been done and wrapped up, and then if you wanted to do like a sequel story or something, you know, new cast of characters, new bad guy. Like, you don't have to keep having the same, you know, cast of heroes going after the same fill-in for 100 chapters if you only need 30 to get the story wrapped up, you know? Like, you can do something else. I think BBC technically ended with a free fair. I mean, some shouldn't do that, like Bleach. Well, okay, with Bleach, they do, but they don't, I feel like. Because it's still all about the power creep, because then it's like, well, here's the new big bad and stuff. It's like, no, just give us the same universe, but a different protag. It doesn't need to be Ichigo still. It can be somebody else. Like, because, yeah, I think I fell off Bleach with Aizen. Which I think is... Is that where the anime ended? I don't remember. But yeah, I don't blame you. Or like, have any of you guys heard of Katekyo Hitman Reborn? That was one that I got really, really into. I really, really liked it. And like, to this day, I really like Reborn. I think it's fun. But at the same time, it's like, all the character growth, they would throw it out the window. It's like, bruh, what did you do to Suna? He was so much better, but they just threw it out the window. And I started, but I never got past it. Dude, Leech has his charm after the first society arc. That's fair. Like, that's fair, though, Axel. It does. Like, it's... I don't know. Never got past episode 10. I think it's good, Lumi. Like, it takes a while to get good. But once you get into, the first, like, real fill-in group, it gets really interesting. I've heard about it, but I haven't seen it yet. Okay, so the thing is, I would probably recommend the manga. Because, admittedly, the anime... I really liked the anime. I really, really enjoyed anime. And, like, the way they did power creep was still kind of stupid and ridiculous. But it's one of those... It's one of the ones that I actually got through the longest. because they still managed to keep my interest with the story and stuff. And then they lost Suna's character development when I was... Anyway. For the anime, I can't in good conscience recommend the anime necessarily. It's good. I really like it. The openings are jams. Like, the openings are so fucking good. The last, I want to say, 150 episodes are all one arc because they fucked around and I don't think the manga was done by that point. And how they managed to make it 100 some odd fucking episodes for one arc, I don't know. But I never finished the anime because of that. So I would recommend the manga, because there are some arcs in the manga that didn't get animated because they all stuck in the future for the 100 fucking episodes. But the manga was good for the most part. Like, admittedly, like, they did Suna really dirty, but overall it was pretty good. I liked the characters. I liked the character development before they decided to throw out the window. Like, the different groups, like, it was a power... See, this is what I mean. Sometimes you can have a nice big chunk, and it's like, oh yeah, we're done. And then other times, like, with the Keel, or it's like, you're missing this one speck of dirt, and I refuse to be done until you find it. God, I hate this game. Anyway, so... But, like, the characters are fun, and, like, they all go through... They go through some emotional arcs. And what's nice about that one is, like... I don't know. I like how... Suna grows into himself. I hate how they still treat him like the same no good Suna by the end. No, that was Gar. But I like how he grows into himself. I like how his friends grow into himself. Like, the baseball boy was my favorite. And, like, he starts off really happy-go-lucky. And, like, by the end, he's still a pretty happy character. But, like, after going through and, like, having the serious attack put against him and his friends, he has... very obvious, you know, character development where he stops and he's like, okay, this isn't a joke, this isn't a game, I have to take this seriously if I want me and my friends to get through this. If I want to protect my friends and my family, I have to buckle down. But, like, stuff like that's really nice. And I mean, I know other shows do it, I don't know, I like the approach to it, I guess. That makes sense. How did this turn into a, hey, say, like, Hell's Cage art of people? I don't know. But here we are. Moral of the story is, don't watch the future. just listen to the OPs. The OPs were really good. EDs were okay. But the OPs is where the music was. Oh, and Suna Awakens. Suna Awakens is a jam. Anyway, so, this is like, I can't in good conscience sell people to Kingdom Hearts, but at the same time, I want everyone to get into the story. I'm here for this right now. Y'all just let me get going. Anyway, so, go look up Katikio Hitman Reborn, do not do the future arc, and you'll be fine. The music really is really good, though. And, like, Suna Awakens to this day is one of my favorite. Like, it's really pumped up song. It's like you say, Ron. It's one of those ones where you just put on it. Yeah, I'm here. Let's go. I guess it's also, like, the time period when you find something like that. Like, it was one of those, I think, it had been around longer. Obviously, but I think I found it when I had first started college, which one of these days I'm gonna go back. So it was just like one of those really inspirational, like, hits you in the right spots at the right time type of things for me. But yeah, it's definitely one of the few shonen shows that I got really into and I was able to stick with. Not till the end, because like I said, the last like 100 episodes are the same arc. And they had little mini arcs inside of them, but it's like, no. Anymore. I don't even care. Please just kill Marshmallow Man. I'm begging you. The manga had some good, like, arcs after, so. And like as the art progressed, it was also one of those ones where you could see the art, their like the art progression. That was really nice. Like by the end, the art was. Anyway, go watch Horimiya. Horimiya is only like 12 episodes. it's a cute one for a romance, though. Like honestly. I can't believe Tokyo Ghoul had to have best box for no pee for as bad as it was. That's amazing. Loved Bleach manga artists. They always had cool. Yeah. Okay. So like the splash art for Bleach, even to this day, that doesn't get old. Honestly, I prefer shorter anime if we go action. What's a good short one that's like action oriented? My brain keeps telling me Toilet Bound Kimono Kunin. I don't think that one counts. That one count. That one doesn't really count as a shonen, does it? What about Hanako? About like, ooh, that's really. Oof, that won't get you in the right places. Back to your topic though, I do need some decent romance. I don't really like the will they won't they stuff. Okay, yeah, that's one thing that drives me insane with a lot of romance anime. I haven't watched Kaguya-sama, but I did hear that one's actually really good for a will they won't they. Because it's not, it's less will they won't they and more who confesses first, what kind of mind games can I play to make the other one do it. But I haven't watched that one. Like I said, Horimiya is only like 12 episodes, but it's really nice. They get together by the end of, was it episode 1 or episode 2? Like they get together really fast, but it's still like organic. It doesn't feel rushed. Because it's very much they're talking and they become friends first. And they slowly come out of their shells and like start being super honest with each other. And it's really, really cute. And Miyamura Kun is precious. Miyamura is the best. I love him. And like, especially when he goes and he drops his hair off to look better, to stand next to her, even though she would never ask it of him. Okay. What's some other good romance? As I blink, I'm literally anything I've ever swatched ever. There's some other, like, if anybody else has like recommendations, like let's hear them. Like I know I think I've had this come, I know I've had this a few times with chat. Like Mari will tell you, you know, go watch stuff like Chainsaw Man or with like Trigon, and I'm not big on that type of stuff, but I came back and on the evolution you can. Okay, but then it ends right once it's going somewhere. Extra what? We're really anime now. But if you've got any like good romance ones that aren't super heavy on the will they won't they, let's hang and leave limbo for the next 20 years. That'd be nice. I say Horimiya. I really like Horimiya. But and like, hey, if you've ever watched the VTuber Sayu, Horimiya, he plays Miyamura-kun in Horimiya. But yeah, I really like that one. Yeah, I want to see romance that are buddy. Okay, honestly, my favorite is Recovery from MMO Junkie. I've heard good things about that one. I don't think I've watched that one myself, but it's a bit will they won't say, but it's so funny. Nana I hear is really good too, but I know it gets really good. This is good for like every 4 episodes. When they try to do visual novels and like otome games like that, I know it can get really weird really. Oh, speaking of more mature characters, what's the one that, I haven't started it, but I really, really want to. The one about the guy with the ice powers on, like, it's in an office setting, I think? I've watched clips of it, and it looks really good. And then there's stuff like Regretsuko, but the romance. Honest, my favorite anime ever, but it's most nihilistically depressing series ever. Yeah, I hear that one gets really dark. I couldn't get into it. I think that's one. I remember looking at that one back in high school. I just couldn't get into it personally, but that's so damn good. What is the one? Like I said, there's one that's newer. And I don't remember what it is. I just know the guy's got like ice powers and it's in a office setting, so it's definitely an older crime. Or there's one about the some like, don't believe me some kids. No, what is it? I'm thinking not Toro or whatever her name is. There's one that's with a really short girl or woman. She's that's another office setting one, but like she's I remember seeing clips of like her and the guy that's really tall and she gets mad about like him teasing her and stuff, but they like each other and blah blah blah. There's a few older setting ones that I want to check out. There's also the Love is for Otaku one. We really need to have another anime night on Discord soon. We can just go back. I want to watch more of like the My Roommate's a Cat or whatever it's called. That was cute. We need to watch more Gundam. We can just watch like office romances. As long as it's not on Friday. I'll have to figure that out. That'd be fun though. That was a lot of fun the first time. Even if it was very impromptu. Like it was very much a okay, anyway. But since Kadris helped us and figured out how to watch the stuff on Crunchyroll. Kadris and General What? Between the two of them, we actually figured it out. So. You can watch stuff on Crunchyroll or we can watch it on other sites. Taken on Friday, Sunday, and Monday. That's fair. I feel like a weekend, like Saturday might be a good one then depending on like when everyone's free and stuff. Just cause it is a weekend, so most people, like not everyone, a lot of people are off on Sundays. Or like alternating it. Saturday makes sense just because of Toonami. Childhood nostalgia. That will get you every time. Maybe my mama. Yeah. So wait, yeah. And like I said, if anybody wants to recommend, if you're on Discord, go to my channel, start recommending songs. I'm still kinda mad that I realized I could have done karaoke today and today would have been like the perfect day to do it. But Saturdays when you watch anime. True. Ants, let me tell you right now, honey. Some of it's going to be in English, and you are not allowed to complain. If we actually start doing this more regularly, some of it's going to be in English, and you are going to have to deal with it. Because AWIX needs to be in English sometimes. Saturday night and my night. I complain about Genshin, not everything. No, you've complained more than once about other things too, hun. Don't even. Saturday night and my night. Yeah, that might be fun though. We want to try that tonight. Well, tonight might probably be too short notice. Let me see if anything's going on next weekend. Sorry, I have high standards. There's being high and high standards, and then there's just being me. But anyway, we're going to drop the argument for that. And I'm going to see. Let me see if anything's going on next Saturday. Do you think next Saturday might be a good day? If you do, you do. So, because tonight I might be able to do that, but I doubt it. I don't know. I'll have to stop and look. Just do them in prompt. Hey, if anyone's around who wants to watch anime, let's go. Who knows what we're watching, but let's go. Last time was really fun, though. Just sitting there, and I don't know how you all got me into fucking Gundam, but you did. And then, like, the roommate's a cat one was adorable. Legit watch roommate as a cat. That was so cute. Like, that was precious. I was really enjoying that. It gets better, does it? Oh, okay. Yeah. It was really sweet. And I'm going to drag more people than Horimi with me if I have to drag them kicking and screaming. And more wholesome. Aww. Yeah, that one was really... Or, like, I want to watch Cheese Sweet Home. Didn't have a whole lot, it looked like. But watch a little bit more Cheese Sweet Home. That'd be cute. we can talk. We can maybe later today then. I'm not making any promises because middle brother works until like 7 or 8 or something. And I don't know when they're going to be back with my niece. So I don't know what's going on. If it happens, I will ping everybody on Discord. You think I should make a channel just for like movie night recommendations and stuff? I also, like I said, if anybody wants to put karaoke, I'm still, I can't believe I could have done karaoke today. I don't know. Oh well. It'd be a good idea. Okay, yeah. I will sit down and figure out how I want to phrase that and where to put it and. Okay. Cool. Speaking of not knowing what's going on, I don't know if they're going to be bringing home food or not, but I'm starting to get a bit hungry, so I might go ahead and wrap up here soon and then go find something to eat. But like I said, if I decide to do something, I'll peek it. But if not, we can tentatively gun for next weekend, and I can see about getting channel set up for like recommending stuff. Like, yeah. Maybe doing one for like chatting just for like movie related, like when we watch anime or shows or whatever. I should make y'all watch Promare with me. The one, I don't even think Promare counts. It's not a mech movie, but like there are mechs in it, I guess, technically. Pass on Promare. You can watch if you don't want to. I just really like it. Promare is one of those ones. I don't know. I'm surprised I like it as much as I do. Like, I wasn't expecting to fall into that rabbit hole. I did. I fell hard. Like, that's not typically the type of movie that I get drugged into, but, like, whatever reason, I absolutely adore it. Can we get along very well with my other friend who loves Promare? Ooh. Yeah. What you do is you make them join Manor so that we can talk about Promare while we watch it. Like I said, I don't know. That's not typically... I don't normally do, like, trigger really hard. I don't do, like, mecha or aliens or anything like that. But for whatever reason, something about Promare got me hard. Like, it got me really bad. Like, to the point where... Okay, so I know there's the one scene with Leo and Gal... that if you know, you know. I was actually kind of pissed because I was like really emotional and really into it, and then these kids behind me start cheering. It's like, shut up, because I was actually really into it. And a chance dragged Salix and the Gundam kicking and screaming. True. Brace it. look, I'm not the one. I can't even say I'm saying so, it's a joke. Look, if you want to take it the wrong way, I don't see how that's a me problem. I know what I said, and you know how I meant it. It's hardly my fault if you took it the wrong way. Yeah. Would it be better to say it put me in a chokehold? Hmm? Apparently, like, it's good enough that like, it actually got, my niece is, like, 6, remember? So, like, I've had her, She really, really likes Premiere to the point where I had to get her her own copy of it. Oh, it's like, it's not just a me thing either. Apparently, you got, like, my niece really liked it too, so.
But yeah. Okay, I think I might go ahead after I get this spot.
I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up for now. For those who don't know, if you follow Maritar Fiti, she's going to, or I think it's tonight, right? She should be doing a 1 year Annie stream. So be ready for that. Is it Mari or is it Do? Or not Do, Pim. Pim's tomorrow, I think. That was last night. Oh, so it might be Pim tonight then. Oh, Pim. Okay, okay. Look, there's three of them. I know it's Pim, Lumps, and Mari. I don't remember who's when what. So it's Pim. Pim's doing a 1 year thing. I think Lumps too. So if it's Pim tonight, it's gonna be Lumps tomorrow. I just knew it was like the three of them all in like a row. So yeah. So Pimmy's gonna be doing thing. And I think are you doing that with her, Lumi? Was it you and Do maybe? Like you and it was I know it was Pim, Lumina, and somebody else were gonna be playing Risk of Rain together, I think. So go check out my friends because they are lovely people. Risky Rain, yee! Yeah. So Lumi's right here. So hang out with Lumi, hang out with Pimmy, hang out. I already follow him. Good. But like if you don't follow, they're gonna be doing Risk of Rain for a 1 year anniversary for Pim. And then Lums is probably doing something for tomorrow because no way in hell he's on it. So go hang out with my friends tonight. So yeah, I can't do movie night tonight. It's a 1 year anything. We can talk about it next week. But go hang out with Lumina. Go hang out with Pimmy. Go hang out with whoever else is going to be on Pimmy's thing. And hopefully I will see you guys tomorrow. I don't know if I'm going to do Genshin because all it's going to be is exploration. But tomorrow's Genshin Sunday, so we'll see. And before then, let me see. Great. Sino's doing stuff. Do I want to raid Sino? No, that would make me highly uncomfortable. I want to say yes because I really like Sino as a person, but like he's one of those big. Nope. Have a good rest of your day and thanks for streaming. Thanks for hanging out for a little bit. And oh, okay. So Gray's doing Dungeons and Dragons. I just read Gray because we were talking about TTRPGs earlier. So let's go hang out with her. But yeah, thank you guys for hanging out with me for a while. And like I said, you'll probably see. It may or not be Genshin, it may be something else. It might be another normal movie. Okay, we'll see. But until then, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.